Sylvia's story. Sylvia walked into her first period class. It was a Monday, and Mondays were always the worst. She was tired and kind of grumpy and counting down the days to the next weekend. There were still several minutes until the tardy bell, but Sylvia took her seat at the back of the room anyway. Quite a few of her classmates were grouped together, having conversations about their weekends, or their boyfriends or girlfriends, or if you were part of the SMART group, what tests were coming up this week. Sylvia wasn't really part of any group in particular. If her teachers were to describe her, they would say things like polite, quiet, and keeps to herself. If one were to ask her peers, they would definitely say nerd, weirdo, or maybe even freak. It's funny, you know, Sylvia thought to herself, the labels that people have for one another. Her grades weren't terrible, but they weren't the best either, so she really didn't think she qualified as a nerd. She felt like she lived a pretty normal life, with a mom, dad, and brother, with no shortage of love at home, so she didn't feel like a weirdo or freak either. In fact, she felt like a pretty normal teenager. She just didn't feel the need to try to fit in all the time. But she wasn't stupid, and she knew what the other students thought of her, and that was either the cause, or the effect, or both, of her not fitting in. That being said, Sylvia was not a total loner. She did have a few people in her classes that she would talk to. She also had Christy, her best friend, since the first grade. She probably hung out with Christy the most. The only problem was that Christy had recently found herself a boyfriend, good old what's-his-name, which left little time for their friendship. Sylvia tried desperately not to let it hurt her feelings too much, but it was difficult. It was especially hard since her other best friend, May, had moved to another part of Plano this past summer, so they would no longer be going to the same high school. She saw May on the weekends and everything, but not having her at school made Sylvia feel even more alone. Sitting at the lunch table with Christy and what's-his-name really wasn't her idea of fun. The first period bell still hadn't rung, so Sylvia opened up her phone to check her Facebook. She sighed and decided to update her status. Sylvia wrote, "I have a serious case of the Mondays." She thought to herself that Facebook was kind of funny because even though she didn't have all that many real-life friends, she had quite a few Facebook friends. These were even people that pretended that she didn't exist at school. She called these people Facebook Friend Collectors, or FFCs for short. They were trying to enlarge their social network to include the largest number of people possible, almost like a contest to see how many friends they could collect. Sylvia sat fiddling with her phone and was sort of lost in her own thought when she heard her name being whispered by someone somewhere close to her. Four girls huddled around a phone were whispering, laughing, and shooting quick glances over towards Sylvia. People are so dense sometimes. They think that just because they are whispering that no one can hear them, Sylvia thought to herself. Now Sylvia was tuned into the conversation. One of the girls, Tara, whispered Sylvia's name again. And then she said, "Facebook." Then Tara giggled quietly and said, "Case of the Mondays? It's more like a case of the uglies." The other three girls laughed along with Tara. Sylvia couldn't believe it. They were obviously making fun of her Facebook post and calling her ugly. On a daily basis, Sylvia tried so hard just to blend into the background as to avoid situations such as this. She figured that if she just kept to herself, she wouldn't give anyone any kind of excuse to make fun of her. Those girls were prime examples of FFCs, and she had ignorantly accepted their friend request and become part of their collection. Sylvia hadn't realized that by clicking accept, that it opened the door for these girls to hurt her. She knew that they weren't her true friends, but at that moment, Sylvia realized just how hollow the word friend really was, especially when it came to Facebook. Sure, she kept to herself and acted like a bit of a loner, but the truth was that what the girls had said stung badly. She had just about a minute left before first period would start, and Sylvia intended to make the best of it. By this time, her hurt feelings had boiled over into intense anger. She would get back at them and make them think twice about picking on her or anyone else for that matter. For the second time that morning, she took out her phone and opened up Facebook. With all the venom and hatred she could muster, Sylvia started a new post and wrote, "To Tara Cates, Brittany Gomez, Paige Peters, and Andrea Polchek, the four of you are the ugliest, hateful witches that have ever walked the halls of this school. You all deserve to die. My advice, grow eyes in the back of your heads, because I will stab every single one of you eventually."